I was seeing my general practitioner every 6 months because of my diabetes. At one appointment, after some blood work, he told me that my liver enzymes were elevated and I had a fatty liver. He didn't make a big deal of it, so I didn't think much of it. He told me I should lose some weight, but I heard that at every doctor's appointment, so that didn't set off any warning bells. At the next appointment, he told me I had NASH, and I also might have cirrhosis. I was shocked.
Something that's very important for us to understand is that fatty liver disease is a very chronic and largely silent disease as it progresses. But what's really scary are the number of people who progress to cirrhosis and present for the first time when they develop a complication of cirrhosis, because our options at that point are so limited.
I went 9 years between my fatty liver diagnosis and my cirrhosis diagnosis. 9 years. That was 18 doctor's visits. I'm no physician, but I know the cirrhosis didn't occur between my 17th and 18th visit. It happened over time, but I was not aware of it.
I cannot even begin to tell you how often we see patients who've been told, you have a little elevation of liver enzyme, don't worry about it. When the patient eventually is diagnosed with cirrhosis and they come to us, and we look back at their records, and we say for 10 years, the person's liver enzymes have been elevated, and nobody's ever talked to them about it. This happens again and again and again. So there's a tremendous unmet need for us to increase the awareness about liver disease, but this is really important because fatty liver disease has emerged as a major cause of morbidity within this population.
Talk to your physician about the kinds of tests that ought to be done. And in my experience has been, in some cases, that the patient needs to initiate those discussions. If you're aware of it early, you can take action early and hopefully stop the progression.